Coach Cole. Coming back to Jersey, and Jersey native, coming back to Jersey, got involved in coaching high school football. Spent 2 seasons at Ferris High School in Jersey City, New Jersey. And actually went back to my alma mater, my high school, North Carolina High School. Took on the office coordinator role there for 5 seasons. Had 2,000 seasons there, and right before the 2022 season. Lucky enough to get back to my alma mater, back to the University of Maine. Had a great time there. Continue to grow my love for the game. Get right into it. The attributes of a great running back. Things we look for when evaluating running backs. All right, first thing, again, vision. Of course, running back, you know, if you don't have vision, you're going to have a hard time doing anything. You can be as fast as you want, you can be as powerful as you want. If you're not in the right hole at the right time, you're going to have a hard time losing, you know, especially at the higher level. Maybe at the lower levels, you might be able to get away with just being fast down the field and producing. But you're going to have to have vision to hit the right hole once you get up into a higher level, more competitive levels there. Next thing to look for is balance, particularly contact balance. You know, are you able to take a hit and keep your feet moving? Are you able to roll the punch in time, bounce off the tackle, and redirect yourself, get back on, work yourself? Those guys who just get hit, they're just getting tripped up, stumbling. Those guys usually don't last long at the higher level. Next thing is COD, that's changing direction. Are you able to change direction suddenly? Sometimes you'll see take guys take 3-4 steps to get into a cut. We had to have that ability. You know, coaches draw all different types of cuts. You have to stick cut, you have to cut. But the quicker you can make a cut, the more set you can be in making your cut, the better off you'll be. Once you start chopping your feet up, you give an indicator to the defense. You're changing directions. What are they going to do? They're going to slow yourself down and ready to change directions. So the more settled you can be in those rooms, the better off you'll be, the more production you'll get. Alright, next thing you have burst and acceleration. That's one thing you'll see. We try to teach every single drill we do with running backs with a burst. Alright, just quick fire our burst at every single drill. Alright, that's more important to me. Of course we all want those 4-3, 4-4 guys that can take the house when you play. But your burst is more important to me. That's going to show up on every single play. That's going to show up every play. Those opportunities to take a run 6 yards only going to happen once so often. But your ability to get from top speed in an instant, that shows up just about every single play you touch the ball with running back. So if I take a guy who runs a 1.5, 10, he might run a 4.6, 40, but when a guy who runs a 4.4 or 4.5, he can't burst, he can't get top speed. Of course, one guys that finish runs physically, move piles forward, run through arm tackles, have to be able to do all those things. Then your mentality. I believe that running back is one of the most physically demanding positions on the football field. It's from the simple fact that you're expected to run with DBs. They also expect to get into the trenches and bang with line, defensive line, and bang with line there at the same time. So you got that mentality, you got to take on that approach that you're going to face to deal with those challenges. BYOB, right, that's how we create explosive runs. Right? That's not bring your own bear, be your own blocker. Right? So I tell my guys in the running back room, simple math, there's 11 guys on the field for offense, 11 guys on the field for defense. No matter what we do, right, we go 10 for 10 on our box, 9 for 9, and you have your QB holding that backside defender with his run cell and his pass kick after handing the ball off. Right, no matter what you do, there's still going to be one free hitter out there, and we have to make this. That's when BYOB comes into play. No matter where he comes from, no matter when he gets there, you're going to have to BYOB running up, make at least one guy miss. And that's the running back down on every single play. You got to make at least one guy miss. Four guys you can't miss, better off you'll get. But you got to at least one guy miss. You can't make one guy miss, you should be the guy getting the ball 20 times again. So how are we going to BYOB? What are the main things we're going to BYOB? All right, being elusive. Talk about making that guy miss, creating yards after contact. We want those backs to get about 50% of their yards coming after contact. All right, they're getting tackled, and you're just getting with your O-line blocks up, and you're getting 3-4 yards of play. That's cool. But just about everybody can do that. You know, you got 40 yards to still get the whole get 4 yards. So if you can't create, you can't move piles forward or break tackles, you're probably not going to be able to get the ball. every time you touch the ball, all the other guys on the defense are responding to the path that you're moving at. Once you make your cut, they're responding to you making your cut. So you have to be able to manipulate angles, change tempo. The use of the offense, right? This is one thing that I don't think backs do nearly enough. You have some backs who utilize the offense, great, and some backs don't utilize it enough. Right? So not only stiff form, you got to be able to carry arm tackles, oncoming arm tackles. We also take a look at the throw by drill that we utilize. Then, of course, eliminating tackle service. That's lowering your pads, getting those pads down, running through the trenches. All right. And also, at times, just taking away your tackle service. We'll take a look at that in some of these drills as well. All right. So that's good. All these things going to develop in the second level back. Other thing I like to say, with all these drills, we're going to talk about all these drills, and we're going to see how they apply to game situations. So like I said, if you didn't drill it or if you didn't teach your guys, you can expect your guys to show up and do it on game day. Because right? I'm a firm believer. I don't know where it originated from, but the first person I heard say was Andy Johnson, motivational speaker. All right, under pressure, we don't rise to the occasion. We revert back to the level of your training. So if you've never been in that situation, never had your guy in that situation, don't expect him to come out successful. Alright, so the first drill we'll go over, these first couple of drills, are just looking at your max ability to move efficiently. So the first we got is called lateral shifters. Alright, so it's repetitive motion, we'll take a look at it. Players will gain comfort, understanding their foot placement, changing levels of their hips, and then distributing their body weight when they're making cuts. These transition from making lateral movements stepping slightly outside of the frame of their body, which is going to help them influence defenders, stepping outside the frame of their body. Then on the second go call, you'll see them transition from moving laterally to getting vertical as fast as possible. So we'll go ahead into the drill, take a quick look at it. We have it right here on the line, so you can see when they transition. Are they wasting steps? Are they once they get that second go call or that second whistle, are they planting that foot in the ground? Getting out forward with good forward body movement. Alright, so open that fair. First go call. You want to see the hips change level slightly. A little tough to see here. Back's right in front of them. But the second part of it, so you see foot placement, good foot placement, stepping outside the frame of the body. Alright, hips changing levels. And the second go call. Alright, you see left foot plant right here, you're looking down here, 46, left foot plant in the ground. That next step is gaining ground. That next step should be off the right. That's how you know they're transitioning. They're not taking too many steps in the same spot, being efficient with their footwork. All right, then you just finish with a burst. All right, just give them a cut to me. Just cut them 45 degrees into your right hand. All right, next up here. Get a look at it. You see 22, he's doing a good job. Transition the hips, you see the hips changing levels there. All right, one thing you do see in 22 here though, probably when his first time doing this drill, he's got wasted motion coming when he's transitioning from moving lateral going forward. All right, 22, you see he takes about 3 steps in the same spot before he actually gets going forward. Check his feet here. 3 steps in the same spot before he gets going forward. As opposed to 35, whistle blows. Right foot's planted, he's already getting going forward, that he doesn't have another step in white. His next step is going right to the green. So just being efficient with our steps did. Just get the variations of it. It'll always start off the same, and then just have to cut on different angles. So now we have the gap cut, we're going to have to seek that, focus on seeking the hips more to change direction. All right. Set and sink the hips, drive out of that. All right, just go back and restart it. Top of the cone here. Alright, once again, 22 stepping right in the same spot. Plants on that right foot, steps right in the same spot, steps in the same spot with that left foot. Alright, just an easy way to see your guys being efficient with their footwork. Alright, showing these things would be a lot easier to clean up their footwork, make sure they're being efficient. Alright, next thing you have here, see 25. Starts the same way. Alright, see 25 doing a good job with the ankle. Planting on that left foot. All right, you see him, the shin angle, all right, getting around that cone, dropping the hips. This is what we want, that shin angle. That foot's getting going back in the opposite direction. He's on a little bit more of a flatter angle here, so it's going to take him a little bit more time. Of course, it takes a little bit looser hips to be able to make this cut. But it's a good indication for you. All right, next we got lateral back burst. Another one where you can see how efficient your players are being with their movement. All right. So back players are just going over bags. All right. Main thing here, you want to make sure they're not wasting steps. Sure, they're gaining ground every step, so they go lateral in each direction, just utilize the three bags, and then they'll plant on that outside foot, and they'll get going forward. So second part of this, you'll see them increasing, you see their ability to run with forward lean when they're going into their acceleration phase here.
Sudden versus vertical.
Garrett. Garrett's from Power. Good job, patient. I'm pulling guard. This is the cut right here. He's trying to sort his way through. All right, sees the defender's out of control, swine across his face, sticks that right foot on the ground, gets vertical. All right, finishes the run. Would like to see him finish running through contacts that run out of bounds, but still a very productive run here. clip up of here. Stiff arm, running through contact. All right. Good job ripping that near leg through. Not spending a lot of time in the area. Hurdle over, get back on the ground, get back moving forward. All right, here, not exactly what we want here with the hurdle. All right, see him jumping off the near leg. All right, so if he's finished coming towards you, you're giving him more of an opportunity to actually impact when hit that left leg. All right, you want to rip that near leg through, jump off the opposite leg. All right, some opportunities here, see some game application. All right, so I'm just flipping with a stiff arm. Then using a stiff arm, trying to come to the body, that's a good job. Jabbing it out there, not leaving it out there, just print the grab. Get accurate with it, and you also get a hurdle. Same foot. One thing I will say here, we would like to see, you got about 36. Got to get to the 14-yard line to get a first down. Don't get the first down. Don't run out of bounds at 1 yard. Details there. We went forward on fourth and one, picked it up, but don't get the first down. Don't leave it for the next down. But that's what we mean here. That's a good job. Jumping off the opposite leg, working that right leg through. Creating some excitement for the guys on the sideline there. All right, so this one here is seeing if the guy comes through at the medium, running through contact. Dropping those pads, running through contact here. Not giving them much good. All right, we see on the finish, he gets that right leg caught, can't get that foot back in the ground. He hit an impact on the right leg, can't get it in the ground. He ends up taking a little bit of a hit here. Initial run through on the backside safety number zero coming through. Does a great job. Just going on the pad level, not slowing the feet down at all, running through contact here. Another clip for Junior, why not? A little wildcat package here. Back does a good job running through the arm tackle here once again. All right, getting out in the open field, utilizing the stiff arm here, getting contact at the 30-yard line. Which we get in, but we get another 29 yards. We utilize the stiff arm at the right time here. Any opportunity we get to create more yards at the contact. Stiff arm here. All right, with this stiff arm, if you use this on different, work this on different angles, Right now, they're just as if the defender's coming at you from the front, just want to push him into the ground. All right, they're also utilizing the stiff arm coming from the side. Like, see, they'll be a little bit more aggressive with that throw by. All right, good with it. Second hand. All right, here, this is what we're doing underneath the shoe. You want to step, but see right here, he's hopping. It's a little bit of a hop here. Not as clean as you want, not a great rep. Getting a little gas here, got to finish reverse. All right, that's better footwork underneath the shoe here. And over the top. He does wrong, that hand's kind of high, it's a little bit of a wind up. We don't want to wind up as much. We'll generate enough power without the big wind up. So, throw by, utilize this in two situations. We'll take a look at it in a second here. But first incoming tackle, if he's approaching out of control, if he's reaching, just throw him by, get that vertical. All right, or we can also utilize the throw by with that lead blocker out in front of us. We want to direct him to where we want to get him to, reverse vertical. All right, so just using the medicine ball, right, 12-pound medicine ball. Throw that by, reverse vertically. All right, and then just react off me. Whatever hole I step up into, they're cutting away from, dropping pad level, reverse. He does a great job here. Throw by, reverse vertical. All right, you see, only by two steps, he makes a decision, gets vertical. All right, we don't want to take 4 or 5 steps here as we're trying to figure out what cover. He does a good job here, just 2 steps, makes a decision, gets vertical. Same thing here, throw by. Smooth and efficient. All right, clench that left foot, drop those pads, gets vertical. All right, not as clean as a rep here. Just on the finish here, you see, he starts chopping feet almost instantly. All right, we want to press him. We got to get comfortable pressing our points. All right, applying pressure to the defense. We start chopping our feet from too far away. All linebackers gonna see that we're about to change direction. All right, he's gonna slow himself down and he's gonna react to us changing direction. So eliminate a couple of those steps there. Just get a little bit more comfortable pressing vertical. Stiff arm here, throw out here. Keep him tight. reach your primary target. Number five, keep going vertical. Not much wasted motion there. Alright, next one we got the jump cut. Get that? Alright. So this is just training our ability. Alright. Make the appropriate move come out of our jump cut. Alright. Jump cut, one of the best moves a running back can make, but it also takes the most, one of the cuts it takes the most time. So we gotta make sure we're training that, make sure we got the ability to make our next move immediately after coming out of our jump cut. We'll progress on this one. Alright, so right here we're just starting. It's just me out there at time. We'll have two guys out here. We need another running back. Alright, on each side of the shoot here. Basically, I'm telling these guys, we want to press the crease of these agile bags here. We want to try to get as close as we could to that crease and be set on making our cuts. Alright. And as we come out of that second jump cut, we want to try. In our head, we're always getting vertical. Get vertical underneath the chute right now, unless there's something in the hole, and we'll react to that. So if there's something in the hole, that's when we'll make the cut. So right here, we're just telling these guys, either you're bursting and getting up underneath the chute, or if I'm in the hole right here, you're just going to get around, make another cut, get around. All right, we had two guys out here. I'm on this side, I step into the chute, he's going to make the cut, get back over here. All right, vice versa. Guy on this side of the chute steps into it, he's going to cut back outside. So take a look at it here. Does a good job getting deep into the crease of that bag. Alright, could get a little bit tighter. We want to be as accurate as possible with our feet. Alright, I'm in a hole. Does a good job making another cut. First to get vertical. Alright, this is what I mean. This is what we don't want. Alright, look how far the running back is. His left foot is from that crease of the agile bag. He's making it at the top of the agile bag as opposed to the crease. So he's got to press a little bit more before making that cut. Not a bad job here getting the pass down. All right, looks like his eyes may be on the ground. We'll keep those eyes up getting underneath the shoe. Not bad here. All right, great rep up. Come right out of that jump cut, plant on that outside foot, and right back vertical. Rips. All right, utilize this. Great way of beating defense in a tight space. All right, and avoiding a high impact situation. So I'd like to tell my backs, all right, the only time the defense should get a square hit on us is when we're bringing the action to them. Any other time, all right, we should have an answer to avoid them getting a full out a hit on us, a square hit on us. All right, so pressing right to him. All right, we'll step slightly outside the frame of his body. All right, we're just ripping or slipping right up underneath him. All right, taking away that hit surface. Right when they're getting in contact, we just want to rip our shoulder through. So usually whenever hand we have the ball in, we're just going to rip our shoulder through and slip up underneath right through that contact. All right, we're still probably going to get a piece of it, so we got to be strong enough to run through the arm tackle at that point. Square from the counter, same side counter, come back. All right, linebacker probably feels like he has his dead to rights. All right, great job of slipping, taking away that tapping surface at the last moment there, keeping the feet moving. The whole line does a good job, great job pushing the pile. Turn what might be a 2-3 yard run to about a 10 yard run here. All right, just by slipping off that and getting the O-line behind us to push the pile. All right, another situation here. All right, two guys in hold. Got one lead blocker, does a good job taking one. Got another linebacker to deal with. All right, instead of being a kill shot from the linebacker, back does a good job of slipping right up underneath the contact. All right, gotta run through this contact on the lower body though. It's not wrapped up, they gotta run through it. You ever see it right here? In the open field. See if he's flying down, a little out of control. All right, slips up underneath it, creates a few more yards there. Slipping a little bit of the throw by at the same time there from there. Same drill, just attacking from a little bit of a different angle. Have to press a little bit wider. rip. All right, that's just the same idea here. Now you just rip it through with the nine ball and just rip it through the contact here. See if you can type in a view there. First guy is, now he has the safety coming from outside in. All right. Settling out to the contact. All right, this is a good job for avoiding the high impact situation. Just slipping up underneath, getting another 5-6 yards in front of him. All right, half body run through. Similar to the slips and rips, but this is you more in the open field. All right. So when the defender's trailing from the inside out, all right. Defender's trailing from the inside out. Job. All right, by manipulating the angle, by changing the tempo, all right, getting him to overrun it, get him off that near hit, all right, then we'll just get up underneath him, all right, run through half his body. All right, so this is the base way we're running drill, all right, working on the angle here, all right, dropping at a pad level, all right, just rip it back underneath that body here. Accelerate through contact. blocking. All right, that's a good job. Run through contact there. Early in the game, set the tempo. Similar idea here. And he's coming through, making a move after coming out and shoot. Okay, I'm telling the backs, after you come out and shoot, make any move you want to when it pop up. It's up to you what move you want to make. All right, times I might tell them exactly what move we want to work today. This today was going to work whatever move you wanted to work.
Forward would be our react. We got him covered up, get moving on it, and right up underneath there, get vertical.
evaluating to get up on campuses. Our junior days is April 6th, April 13th, and April 20th. April 20th being our spring ball game. It's a great day to get guys up there, get them on campus. We get them in our database, give them some more information about the university. We get some more information about them as prospects. All right, and this is our spring schedule. We'd like to stop in. We'd like to stop in for practice. Talk ball a little bit. Just in case to get up here. Questions, concerns? No good. Thank you, fellas.